What's up, guys? What we're going to do today is continue the video basic series, this time taking a look at shutter speed. Now, of course, that's something you normally associate with a still camera, but with more and more high-end camcorders becoming affordable, and of course, the advent of the video SLR, it's become something that videographers need to think about as well. That being said, though, still the best way to learn is by first taking a look at one of these. So let's go ahead and get started. Let's begin by talking about what exactly a shutter is. Well, as the name implies, it's something that opens and shuts. It's essentially a door on the inside of the camera, which opens to expose the film, or the sensor in the case of digital, and bring in light. The longer the shutter is open for, the more light is hitting the sensor. However, the longer you have it open, because that time is passing, you might end up having more of a blur to your images, depending on how long you have that shutter open for. Shutter speed is normally measured in fractions of a second. So, for example, on this control dial, you see that it's at 30, and that actually stands for 1/30th of a second. So how does this relate to video? Well, video is really just a series of still images moving by at a rapid rate to give the illusion of motion. That rate is the frame rate. Now, that's often confused with shutter speed, but they are very different. They are, however, interrelated. So as each frame is going by, the shutter is exposing it for a certain amount of time, and then just moving to the next frame and so on and so on. So that really begs the question, what shutter speed should you use for a specific frame rate? And the standard rule of thumb is called the double the frame rate rule. Let's say you're using 30 frames per second. So 30 still images going by every single second. You should use 1/60th of a second shutter speed. So each one is exposed for 1/60th of a second as it goes by. Now, you don't always need to do that though, because like every rule, there are exceptions. And the big one people always bring up is the movie Saving Private Ryan. It was shot at a higher shutter speed to give that kind of choppy but crisp motion to it in the action scenes. So really, you just need to experiment and find out what works best for you. A great way to experiment with this is by videotaping water. If you'll notice, if you shoot at, say, 1/60th of a second, you'll get nice smooth motion in the water. Where if you shoot at 1/400th of a second, you'll get kind of choppy but very crisp looking water droplets. So that is shutter speed. In the next installment of Video Basics, we're going to go over frame rate, which I mentioned earlier. If you have any questions on this, just go ahead and leave a comment below. Keep in mind though, I'm still traveling, so it might be a while before I get back to you. As always, thanks for watching, and I'll see you guys next time.